It's been kind of a whirlwind couple of months. I mean, I've known Gruden for a lot of years, but, you know, you walk in at 5:30 in the morning, he looks at you, why are you late? You know, I've been here an hour. So it's been awesome. It's a little different, and I'm really excited about the week. What's different, though, is evaluating free agency this year, for instance. So while I had my scouts in for 2 weeks, we went 15 straight days, 12 hours a day, sitting in a room with the scouts, putting together our first draft board. But I'd have to jump in and out for free agency, for instance. And I think the difference this week for me is I get more access to the kids, which is helpful. So that's the biggest difference for me this week is we had 2 interviews last night. We're going to have 8 more tonight, 60 overall. The 15 minutes with those kids is critical. The 30 visits in Oakland are critical. The local visits, the more time you get with the kids, I think the better job you do scouting. I've had to do every scheme fit there was, both offensively and defensively. What works in New England? What works in Philly? What works in Chicago? Try and understand how a GM drafts around the league, what coaches look for. And now that I get to sit down with John Gruden and Paul Gunther and define who we are and what we want in our building, and that's been a fun process, and I think it helps our scouts redefine what they're looking for when they're on the road, understanding what Paul Gunther's defensive end looks like, what John Gruden's X receiver looks like. So I think everything over the last 18 or 20 years has helped me get to a point where I feel comfortable stepping in a room and talking about scheme with John. But I think you're also trying to get take the temperature of all the players. And that's, again, where I'm most excited this week. And we met a couple of kids last night. We have more tonight, 60 overall. How do they react in the interview room when you challenge them a little bit? How do they react after they run a 40 and they don't think they ran well? You know, there's a lot of nuance to it, and we're just trying to figure the kid out. What makes the kid tick, I think, is more important than anything coming out of this week. Yeah, I am the rookie, and you know, it's ironic that you kind of walk in as the rookie and you inherit a staff of scouts and personnel people, and that's been really fun. I mentioned that we had draft meetings for 15 straight days, 12 hours a day. You get to know people. You know, you're in an enclosed room, no windows. It gets kind of interesting after about 8 days of that, and you get to know people. I think what I missed more than anything, kind of being a lone ranger, is, you know, it's awesome to sit in your office and watch film all day long and get on the phone and talk teams and all, but having a team you're associated with that you have skin in the game with, to me, is the reason I'm here. I can't wait for the first regular season game, and I can't even imagine what that'll feel like. What I would say about the defensive line in general is that in the last 10 years, I'd say it's the best defensive line group we've seen, both edge rushers and inside guys. I think when you start talking about, you know, the first round of the draft, I think it's going to be dominated by defensive linemen. You know, people ask me that, and it's really intriguing. We have to hit on them, obviously, but what I keep trying to tell our staff from A to Z is those 2 seventh round picks are just as important as the 3 first round picks. And the college free agents that we sign after that are just as important. And we're trying to build a culture and accountability and talent. And we're trying to do all these different things. And I think the important thing is it's easy to focus on the 3 first round picks, but we need to hit throughout the entire draft. We got 10 picks. That could be more or less at the end of the day. But we've got 10 picks, and we value all of them. So we need to hit on a high, high percentage. I think our division, from a playmaker perspective, might put more pressure on the defense than any other division in football, to the point where in my office, the first thing I did when I went in is I had them take all the blinds down and everything else, and I've got an entire wall just of the AFC West. Their rosters, their practice squad, everything, depth charts, all up on one wall, magnetic names, just to reinforce to me every day what we have, the challenges we have. And you start talking about Mahomes and Kelsey and Tyreek Hill and just the entire division. When you look at the depth charts on both sides of the ball with their rosters, we've got a huge challenge ahead of us. I think Derek Carr is a franchise quarterback. I truly believe that. Now, do I also believe that it's a general manager and head coach's job to keep their eyes open to improve any position on a football team? Sure, but I think it's really difficult to try to improve over a franchise quarterback like the one we have in our building right now. I'm excited to see year 2 development in some of our rookies last year. You know, Arden Key. You know, Arden Key had to play more snaps than he probably should have had to play as a rookie last year. He hung in there, especially in the run game. We'd like to see him take a big jump, especially in the pass game this year. That's one guy. Maurice Hurst and P.J. Hall are two defensive tackles that we drafted last year. Really excited about both those kids. P.J. is an explosive guy. He needs to take a big jump in year two. We're expecting a big jump in year two. Thought Hurst had a solid year. Looking for more this year. So I think those guys that we drafted last year early, I think the biggest jump you can get in an NFL career is typically year one to year two, and we're looking for that jump this year.